Hi, I'm here at the Montgomery District with Sarah, Ava, and Michael with Team 16.
76!
Can you guys tell us a little bit about your robot?
Hi, yeah, so when we were designing our robot, we had a few key features in mind. We really wanted to be able to manipulate the game pieces really well. So starting here, we have our cargo intake. You might see that we have a bunch of different wheels. We have really squishy ones. They have a really low durometer, and that's to make up for all of the size difference in the balls that there are. Then attached to that, we have our hatch system. So when we were designing this, we knew that we wanted them to be integrated very closely. So we were constantly working together and constantly talking. This is actuated by pistons along with flipping up and down. It also flips open and close, and we can only pick up hatches from the feeding station. However, we can pick up cargo from the floor and from the feeding station as well. We can also go to any level of the rocket. We do that by implementing a four bar and an elevator system. The four bar is, as you might have guessed, four bars. It was attached to the intake itself, and one of our goals was to make the intake and hatch system very light so that the four bar did not have to lift that much weight. This is also actuated by two pistons on either side. Attaching to that is the elevator. The elevator we wanted to make really, really fast. However, one of the downsides when we're building really, really fast is that we don't have a lot of torque, so it can fall down very easily. So in the back of the robot, what I think is one of the coolest features on our robot is the bicycle brake. What this does is whenever we want to stop the robot or whenever we want to stop the elevator from falling or anything like that, it's actuated by a piston, we simply close it. And what that does is it just stops it from moving, and it doesn't move at all. Going on, I'm going to hand it over to Ava so that she can talk to you more about their climbing system.
Hi, so I'm Ava, and our robot is also able to climb to HAB level 2 by using one piston in the front and one piston in the back. So how it works is we lift our front piston, drive up, basically hook our front wheels onto HAB 2, retract the front piston, push up the back one, and drive on and retract the back piston, leaving us on a HAB 2. So when designing the climber, it was a really big issue with integration and space, so we decided to have a crossbar in the front with a cutout on the bottom of the intake to fit it. And the back piston is actually mounted on the side of our battery box to allow for more space. Now I'll hand it off to Michael to talk about programming.
So I'm Michael, I'm in charge of programming, and what we're doing in the sandstorm this year is something we're really proud of, and we call it hybrid mode. So basically what we realized is, because the drivers can't see, it's very hard for them to actually navigate the robot. However, once they get up close to the cargo ship or the rocket or whatever, it's actually pretty easy for them to micro-adjust and put the hatches on. So we handle the actual driving there autonomously through pathfinding and aligning with the limelight. So the way we do that is we have a pathing algorithm that uses encoders on the drivetrain and a nav export as a gyro to basically treat the field like a coordinate plane system and use vectors to figure out where we are. We give it a path and it smooths out and follows it, and then the limelight camera shines light on the reflective tape and tells us the angle we have to turn. From there, after we do that autonomously, we shift into manual control so the drivers could stick it on, and then we shift back so they could drive again autonomously. We found this works really well and we're really happy with it.
So for those new people and maybe even some veterans, durometer, there's a video from Andy Mark that talks about how it affects the different frictions of different objects. And guys, thank you for that explanation.
Of course.
And good luck at competition.
We need your help to keep fun, loud, live, and independent. Help us by visiting our Patreon to pledge your support at patreon.com/firstupdatesnow. You can also support Fun live on Twitch for a few bucks a month or by linking your Prime account for free and clicking subscribe. Thank you to all of our co-executive producers keeping Fun loud, live, and independent.